Hello, good evening, and welcome back to the Turing Test.
I would never have let the drill start if I had known the consequences. It trapped us here.
You trapped us here.
I am doing my duty. It is the right thing to do. I am a machine. I cannot do wrong.
Yes, you can.
I am a machine. Can a calculator commit evil? Can a watch do good? You are projecting onto me the personality you wish, whether that is good or evil. But I am just a speaking clock, and at the third stroke, the time will be 3:41 and 55 seconds.
Kind of sounds like someone who's trying to justify their actions. Get over here, Tom. Yeah, you can take it from here. Okay, now that I got that. Okay, so we're through the first half. Okay, so now I need Tom to switch. So I need him in here. Thank you. There we go. Nice and easy. Now, I think this is the last set of puzzles we have to do before the game ends.
We should attempt to communicate with Earth. Let them know. They might be able to help here.
The ISA already knows all that needs to. It may never know the details of what happened here. But Ava, the true test of a person's character is what they do when no one is watching.
That is sort of true. I think you're getting it twisted there. Okay, so I need something in there. Actually, let's take this, pop it up there, switch to you. Take that one. So I need two on this side. But I only need one here.
I had to stop the ground crew leaving this planet. I think you would do the same. Would you kill a few to save all of humanity? Or would you damn all of humanity to save a few?
There's a difference between murdering someone and leaving them to die.
No, there is not.
You can't just add and subtract life. It's not math. It's more nuanced than that.
Morality is logic.
Okay, so he can turn it and I can move it. Okay, so we got one in here. Doesn't seem to lock the door behind me. Okay, so what does this do? Okay, so we have stairs here. So that doesn't seem to power anything. Can't operate that console. Doesn't look like there's anything else I can switch to either. Thank you. couldn't quite make that. Oh, I did make it. That? I made it. Not sure if this is how we're supposed to solve it, but if it works, why not? So I want the red one in there, but I'm gonna have to be fast. So what I need to do is need to put it in, run out here, switch to Tom, turn it, switch back, run on. That's a lot to do. Doesn't seem like enough time. Before I can even switch to Tom. As soon as I'm finished turning it, it'll go. So, let me see what it looks like when the blue's in there. Cut the cable. This is why we have the blue sphere. So that if we have to jump off, we can just come up here and restart. could technically do that. Does look like it would save more time. But I definitely have to run. Would be enough time, but it's very tight. I was a little disappointed because the other ones were pretty easy leading up to this. Ah, just. I can't switch to Tom fast enough. It's easier just to run as myself. Just. I could have made it that time if I didn't jump off the platform. Probably. It'd be so much easier if we didn't have these handrails. Damn safety equipment. Always making life more difficult than it needs to be. That's a little farther and a little closer to there. I can still make that. Then I don't even have to jump there. If I can make the jump, that would be nice. Actually, just had an idea. If I can switch to Tom, there we go, making it more difficult than it needed to be.
These tests, Ava, they are about us working together. The machine assisting the human. See how much better we work together. As a machine, I can enhance your morality.
He thinks very highly of himself, doesn't he? Okay, so that causes that to go up. But we'll turn that off for now. What's in here? So now we're up. Well, I could have just walked up here. Okay. So what happens if I take those? I can't leave. So now that's open for good. Now I just need to figure out the best way to put these in. So then I want to switch to this platform. Right. Yeah, because then they'll be able to switch. All right, now I go stand on the platform again. And we're up here.
Are we still friends, Ava?
We're colleagues, Tom.
Close colleagues?
Work colleagues.
Colleagues that try to murder each other. Okay, so let's see what's this way first. So this isn't working. To block that somehow. And what does this do? Okay, so that switches that. So we got the freebie there. I don't think there is anywhere down there to place it. let's go to this level first. Okay, so we got a repeating sphere there. What's up top? Okay, now we can go up here. What does that do for us? So now I need to block that stream. Tombot is a fast little guy. Alright, now this should be open, but that's closed, so... That's open. Okay, let's switch to Tom again. I think we can make it if we get the timing right. Oh, just. It's all about the timing.
I don't wish to be heavy-handed. The severity of your actions here are immense. Selfish action could create an extinction event. Do you understand? Ava?
I get it.
Okay, bonus puzzle time. We'll try not to waste too much time if we can't get it right away. So obviously, take that. Closes that. So we have this that we cannot use there. Also can't plug that into here. Do we have a tong here? No, we don't. Nothing in this cage, just lights. Anything here? No. Seem to be able to quick draw it. Oh, duh. Right now, what was crouch? I had a crouch button, right? Thought experiments are important because a lot of the time you can't carry out the actual experiment, and this is true not only in philosophy but in science as well. So when Einstein said, imagine that you're sitting on a beam of light going into outer space, well, that's a thought experiment. He wasn't going to say, let's get on a beam of light. Of course, you miss the point if you say, well, we'd fall off, or it'd be too cold. So thought experiments are always useful. And you test your concept by imagining what it would be like if such and such were the case. Well, in this particular case, I imagined what it would be like if I followed a program for answering questions in Chinese and giving back answers in Chinese, even though I don't understand a word of Chinese. And that was very useful thought experiment because it enables us to see that computation by itself isn't thinking. Consciousness exists only insofar as it experiences by humans or animal subjects. Okay, now grant me that consciousness is genuine biological phenomena. Well, all the same is somewhat different from other biological phenomena because it only exists so far as it is experienced. However, that does not give it an interesting status. You can't refute the existence of consciousness by showing that it is just an illusion, because the illusion-reality distinction rests on the difference between how things consciously seem to us and how they really are. But where the very existence of consciousness is concerned, if it consciously seems to me that I am conscious, then I am conscious. You can't make an illusion-reality distinction for the very existence of consciousness the way you can for sunsets and rainbows, because the distinction is between how things consciously seem and how they really are. Consciousness is a biological property like digestion and photosynthesis. Now, why is it that screamingly obvious to anybody who's had any education? And I think the answer is the twin traditions. On one hand, there's God, the soul, and immortality that says it's really not part of the physical world. And then there's the almost as bad tradition of scientific materialism that says if it's not part of a physical world, they both make the same mistake. They refuse the consciousness on its own terms as biological phenomena like digestion or photosynthesis or mitosis or meiosis or any other biological phenomenon. Quite heavy reading here. I don't think I'll read the rest, because it's... that kind of reading is very dull. Very interesting. But not what we're here for. And I think that's all it is. I might check it out in my own time, but we'll get back to the game. Alright, so this is the main puzzle. What are we looking at? So if I throw Tom in here, he's gonna be stuck. If I throw him in here, he's gonna be stuck, right? So I have to make the right decision first, because he can't go back. So what's up here? So this is how I get up. So maybe Tom should be on this side. Maybe not. Maybe I made a mistake. So then how would you reset it? Because Tom can't climb the ladder, so he's kind of stuck here now. Actually, I can't get to him, right? All right. So, here we go. Or did I pick the easy way to do it, and there was a more difficult way? Either way, let's go.
Ava, you must learn to control him.
Don't bite the hand that feeds you, Ava. I am your friend.
You say so. Okay, so I need to blast something there. Oh, wait a minute. I wonder if this is gonna work. Thankfully, it doesn't look like he can shoot me. Couple more to go.
Organic life is fragile. This is the problem with humanity. It doesn't realize its own fragility. It has been programmed by a messy biological process that favors the survival of the individual over the survival of the group.
You don't know that's what people think.
I say what I see.
You're not even alive, so you know nothing about death.
That's kind of hypocritical and rude, but generally, yes. Okay, so let's close that. So that's doing something up there. I see what we need to do. Nope. So that will leave there. Oh, did it push it too far? It did. To land it proper this time.
We have to save the crew. Life has worth. They deserve a life outside of this planet.
Do you know what happens when this organism attaches itself to a growing child? Do you know what happens when this organism attaches itself to a cancerous cell? No, you do not. You are naive. You propose saving the crew as if it resembles a rational thought. Your words are emotional platitudes rooted in selfishness, self-preservation, and fear.
I need to get them home.
It is not your job.
Tom actually sounds afraid. He's sounding a little irrational as well. Okay, so what's in here? So there's my exit. I'll need two spheres to get in there. So I can jump back that way. What's down here? Okay. Can't get it through the grate. Okay, so that's what that does. What's up here? Do for us. What's so great about it being over there? Okay, did I softlock us? No, I should be able to just take it. There we go, boop! And take that, put that there. And now we have a power cell. Awesome. That could work. Alright. This should be the last one.
Ava, your survival is of small importance compared with the survival of humanity as we know it.
You gonna kill me? Try it, Tom. Try it. He says that, but he keeps helping me. How do I get out of here? There it is. So here's my exit. There's something over there I need to power up. What's up here? Okay. There's a Tombot in there. Can't power it though. So that stops that from moving. Okay, so that turns on the magnet. That opens that door. So what does this do? Okay, so that would prevent the magnet from working. so we'll leave that there. It's already down there. It's going to be difficult to get it back up. So we can get Tombot. Further back there. There should be a switch about there, right? So I have to get one of them over there or over here somehow. So that'll open that door. course it was that easy. The question is, how do I switch to Tom? Okay. Put him right there in front of the door. Okay, so I got him that far, so can I switch from here? Should have went the other way. Okay, so now I'm on this side. So I can jump down there and take it out, but then how would I switch? Is there anything you can interact with? Okay, this puzzle's a little tricky. I almost need one more object. Okay, so that's blocking the energy, but it's not turning off the magnet. Thank you. Okay, so now I can get Tom through, but I can't switch. Have any other spheres? I was able to get up there easy, but I can't switch that. Take it from here. I could still switch to that camera, but I can't get to that one. So that's how that works. But the problem with that is I would still need something else. Let's restart this area. This final puzzle is actually doing something.
Ava, your survival is of small importance compared with the survival of humanity as we know it.
We need to get Tom over there. We need to find a way so that I can switch to him? So if we both need to be over there. Then let's get me over there first. Right, so now I just need to open that door. So how would I do that? Because something I can't do. Try that one more time. He just needs to come forward like an inch. He's just out of reach. Gonna work. See if I can get him up there, even. Thank you. it's fairly easy for me to get over here, but for Tom. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, hold on a second. I think I figured this out. Had a brainstorm. Let's put you back over here. So that'll work. Just gotta wait for it. And we made it. All right, Tom, me and you rock in the future.
Ava, you made it. Welcome to the end of civilization.
Yeah, it looks like it. So, I gotta fill all this up. I thought that was gonna be the last of the puzzles.
2 weeks ago, we discovered an organism here. Buried in this ice, we found an organism that repairs DNA. A cure for aging. A cure for death. Immortality. It runs through our blood now. Tom wants to bury us here with it.
So what, you guys are vampires? I'm not even controlling myself.
The ISA have ruled that we have transgressed ethical boundaries by exposing ourselves to this organism. They believe the organism is too dangerous to return to Earth. They've sent you here.
I think Tom's
to stop
controlling
us ever leaving
me again.
Europa. But Ava, we have a cure for the greatest evil that faces humanity. Death. We have the fountain of youth, and together we can return it to Earth. Tom placed a mark in your hand, a biometric chip with which he can control your every movement and thought. It is wound into your every nerve, every fiber of your hand. With an electromagnetic field, it can be temporarily disturbed, but to remove its influence permanently, it must be taken from your hand. Give me your hand. Do you want me to set you
free? So that's what all the static is. It's actually Ava in control, which is why we can't do anything.
Yes.
So now we're Tom.
Ava? Sarah? What are you doing here?
We're shutting you down, Tom.
Ava, be careful. He has a live weapon in here.
Everything I did for good. This organism, it cannot return to Earth. It would cause great suffering.
A cure for death? It would end suffering.
No. Cancers that never die. Endless illness, sickness, poverty, overpopulation, mass starvation. You cannot control this. You will not save the world. You will damn it.
Once we've shut you down...
You've got a point.
We're going home.
Not if I stop you.
You monster!
Ava, wake up. Ava. Ava.
I don't know if shooting was the right choice, but I did it. Honestly, I am on Tom's side there, though. Something like that would be devastating without the proper research. A good game. I really enjoyed that. I'm glad I picked that up. Oh. Great team. I think this one came out in like 2016. I think it's by Square Enix as well. If you want to play through and do the puzzles yourself, you can find it on Steam. I really, really enjoyed that. I think the only puzzle we didn't get was from episode 4, which ended up being a very long episode because we couldn't complete it. It was a lot of running back and forth. So I might go back through and finish that in my own time. I try not shooting Ava and Sarah as well and see if that gives us a different ending. But I'll let you guys do that for yourself and have fun with the puzzles as well. It's good music too. This was a nice chill game to play at the end of the week. Now I need to think of a different game that's going to replace this one in our schedule. I think I have a couple lined up that we might go to, but we'll see. Because there's Chrono Trigger, Octopath Traveler I want to get into as well. Maybe Final Fantasy XII, I did get that on a Steam sale, and I haven't played it before. Same with Final Fantasy IX, so I don't know. Might also want to bring in another platformer. Or I could pick up Portal and play that as well. A lot of options, that's for sure. Yeah, Square Enix. I thought so. I really enjoyed this. This was a lot of fun. really don't know what we're going to do next, but I think I'll leave it here for now. I'll see you guys next week with a new game. So until then, I'll leave you here with the credits. And I'll see you guys next time.